So you're looking for the easiest way to install all the emulators on your Steam Deck. This video is going to be a comprehensive step-by-step guide on how to use EmuDeck to do exactly that. It's pretty straightforward. EmuDeck was created as a launcher so that you don't have to go through and find every single individual emulator and install each one by one. EmuDeck puts it all together in one place, makes it easy to install all the emulators. We're talking Yuzu for your Nintendo Switch, PlayStation 1, 2, 3, all the Game Boys, all the retro games, all of them. It's very comprehensive. So anything that you want, I believe that is everything you need to know. So let's jump into it and get this installed. The first step is easy enough. We're just gonna switch over to desktop mode. Launch your preferred web browser, head to emudeck.com, find the downloads, and then download the SteamOS version. They make this very, very easy. When it finishes downloading, the second step here is just double click on that and say execute. It pops up this window, just say continue. At this point, congratulations, EmuDeck is installing onto your Steam Deck. After it finishes installing, you get to the welcome page. There's two modes that you can do, but today I'm gonna do the custom mode just so that I can set up what I actually want. Select the mode and then hit continue. At this point, you can either set it up to be internal storage or on your micro SD or even on a custom external hard drive. They give you all the options here. I'm gonna do it a little bit different because I'm gonna take my micro SD card out of my old LCD Steam Deck and plug it in right here to my new OLED, but it already has all my games and everything on it, so I'm kind of interested how seamless this is gonna go. Already looking pretty promising, it found the directory and everything, so I'm gonna select it and click next. Now you can pick what device you're doing it, but you know, we're here with the Steam Deck. Now we're to the fun part. You can select all the emulators that you want to install on your Steam Deck. So I'm gonna go through and pick the ones that I actually want, but you can just pick and choose anything you want here. When you finish selecting, click continue. At this point, it prompts you with the option to go individually into each of the emulators and set up custom configurations. I'm not gonna do this. I don't think you need to do this, but if you think you do, then maybe you know more than I do. So we're gonna just say continue and let it do its automatic features.
Oh, hey there. It's so crazy how we keep seeing each other like this. I love your face. It's so nice. But there is this one thing that I really wanted to talk to you about, and it is our Dear Lord and Subscribe button. It's free. It feels really good. Leave a comment. Hit the little thumbs up. It's just a little thumbs up. That's all it is. I just have to reiterate that I'm fine, that I'm doing really well, that I'm happy. I hope you're happy. I don't know. So if it's not too much, subscribe.
I'm leaving, are you? Okay, I'm gonna leave. Continue the tutorial, have fun with it.
Gosh, jeez. Okay, I'll go, okay, bye.
This configure autosave is an awesome feature, and I would suggest to definitely turn it on. In a lot of the emulators, you can hold select and start at the same time, and it'll just automatically shut the game off, but if you relaunch the game, it brings you right back into exactly where you were. That's my elevator pitch. Turn it on, hit next. RetroAchievements are probably cool, but I've never signed up, so I'm gonna hit skip. Configure game bezels. This is for games that don't take up the entire screen. You can just pick whatever you like. I kinda don't like them, or maybe I do? I don't know. You can always change all these settings later. So aspect ratios, we're just gonna go through here quickly and set them to default, or at least that's what I'm gonna do. So nothing is stretched out and looks weird. But again, this is just personal preference. What do you want it to look like? These are all settings that you can change later. So don't stress out about it. Just pick what you think is best. The widescreen hacks are pretty fantastic. So I'm gonna actually turn those ones on. The next set of options are basically like filters to try to make your screen look like a retro old monitor or something. But I'm not gonna do that to my beautiful OLED screen. I want these to look nice. Kind of a perk of emulation. Emulation Station is the one launcher to rule them all. So go ahead and pick whatever theme you think looks cool. Again, you can change this later, so just pick one and let's move on. All right, we've made it. EmuDeck does this awesome little thing where it tells you everything that you've done, and then you can click finish and it will do everything for you. This right here is the entire purpose and existence for EmuDeck. You no longer have to go through each and every single one of these individually, install them, and get them all set up. After EmuDeck finishes installing everything, this is where you go to add games. EmuDeck has an option to easily move all your games from a USB stick. However, all my games are already on my SD card, so I'm gonna say skip for now. At this point, you have completed the installation of all the emulators that you want on your Steam Deck. So it just brings you right back to the welcome page. So now that we have the emulators installed on the Steam Deck, we need to get our games and the BIOS and keys all installed so that everything actually works. To do this, open up your file manager, Dolphin. I have everything installed on my SD card, so I'm gonna go there. And now you can see there's a folder called Emulation. EmuDeck created this. So we're gonna jump inside, and now you can see there's a folder called ROMs and BIOS. It's pretty simple. We're gonna dump all of our ROMs into all the ROM folders. This looks very overwhelming because it is. It's like every single possible emulator has its own folder. Most are pretty easy to decipher what they are, like this Wii folder, which has all my Wii ROMs inside of it. Again, mine are already populated because I had already installed EmuDeck on my old Steam Deck, and I just moved my micro SD card into my new OLED Steam Deck. So all the games were already saved on here. But if you don't have them, it's as easy as dragging and dropping your ROMs into the folders that they need to be. So after you get all your ROMs into the correct folders, go back to the BIOS folder. And this is a similar idea. Just put the BIOS and keys into the folder to the correct emulator. If you don't do this or you put them in the wrong places, don't worry. The only thing that will happen is the emulator won't open. It's not that big of a deal. Just say, okay, go back, try to put the things in the right places. This is probably the most confusing part of the whole process, but believe me, you've got this. I can't tell you where to get these files because you're going to get them off of your device that you own. There's a lot of information out there on how to do this, including from the emulators, like Yuzu has entire articles on how to do this. So check those out. But when you've done it correctly, this is what it should look like. Installing the BIOS and keys was kind of like a jump into the future. So now we're going back to EmuDeck and we're gonna do Steam ROM Manager. This is going to make it all look beautiful and pop up inside of Steam so you can launch it in game mode. I'm gonna full screen this because there is a lot to see, but basically you can go line by line on every single one of these things that you want to get populated inside your Steam library. So just toggle off anything you don't want to see. When you think you've got it, hit preview. It's going to automatically download cover art for all your ROMs and emulators. This is wonderful, people. It automatically does a pretty amazing job, but as you can see, some of my games don't have any cover art for it, but it's easy. You can just click the little arrow and shuffle through any type of art that you want, and you can also upload your own custom art if you want. So I'm gonna go through this and make everything look how I want. When you found all the art that you want, just click Save to Steam. It's gonna do its little magic and get all of these games onto your Steam library, so all of these retro games feel like they're native Steam games. It's pretty awesome. When it finishes saving to Steam, that's it. You can close out of this. In fact, you can close out of everything because, congrats, everything should be good to go. Let's do a quick little test. So we're gonna open up Steam, check out our library, and what do you know? Look at all of those things. And again, you can change anything that you wanna see in here back in EmuDeck. Just what we did, just toggle it on and off. So first off, let's just jump into Yuzu and see what it's looking like. Right away, we can see all of our games in the library, and you can launch any of these games right from there. Right away, everything is already set up and working. Again, another huge benefit to using EmuDeck. Now that we've tested it, everything looks good, let's exit out of everything and go back into gaming mode. When you're in here, you can go to Library and go to Non-Steam. Now all the games and emulators that you switched and toggled on are gonna be in here. And they launch just like any game. Most of the older games are gonna run easily, no problems, no tweaking necessary. However, you'll probably want to increase the resolution on a lot of these other games. But then on newer games, that's where it gets a little bit more complicated and there's a lot of mods and things that you can do to increase the performance on them. But today's video is just going to stay specific for installing EmuDeck and getting all of your ROMs working on the Steam Deck. Which, by the way, if you haven't noticed, we've done it! Congratulations! See, it wasn't so hard.
Or was it?